Eddie? Eddie Glins, Eddie Glines, Edie Glines, Edie Glins, Eddie Glins, I don't know. All right, I don't know who you are, but you asked a great question about the transfer of stimulus control. And you know what? It's a great topic, and you probably noticed that in our regular videos, we've kind of completely skipped over it. There's a particular reason. It's because it just takes a really long time. There's more than one joke embedded in that statement. And really, I'm not trying to be too funny, but I am. It's about the transfer of stimulus control is not something that's easy, and it's not something that you can just pick up and have a checklist with. You kind of got to feel your way through it. You got to find out if stimulus control is transferring. Hold on, I'm getting stimuli here. You can cut this. We're going to cut this brief, and there'll be a little take here, and we're going to come back because
it's a lot of time.
So my cameraman was doing this, and I'm going, is that a time loop? I don't know. So sorry, Eddie. So it can take a lot of time. It can be quick, maybe, if your learner is ready for it and has happened in the past with them, maybe. But it's just one of those things that as a behavior analyst, I think, especially a young behavior analyst, what you want is a clear-cut procedure about how things work. And what you forget, and what you have, maybe you just haven't learned yet, is that being a good behavior analyst takes shaping. In you. You're not, I don't mean that you need to shape me, Eddie. I mean that the world needs to shape you as a behavior analyst. And over time, you're going to figure out how you, a method that's extremely effective for you to transfer stimulus control. And then you're going to realize that that method completely is ineffective on the next person, family, whatever you're working with. It is something that is very challenging. And in general, there's no one procedure. You do have to make sure that you have program for it. And there are things that you can do. For example, if you're working with parents and a kiddo, getting them to handle some of the behavior management techniques, getting them, but not all of them, because there's some weird ethical boundaries in here. Basically, just having them take over certain pieces from you and then you backing off, fading yourself out of that environment. I'm hemming and hawing because there's a lot more that we could get into here. But I just think I want you to realize that it's something that takes time. Work at it. Read about it and read about how others are doing it. Post questions here. Post questions in other Facebook places and see how people deal with their transfer of stimulus control. It might be something that you're great at it with one type of behavior but not another type of behavior. And that's places where you can ask other BCBAs and other behavior analysts how they handle it. So I know this probably doesn't answer your question as well as what you'd like. But I took it as an opportunity to remind you that you still need to be shaped as a behavior analyst. The science of behavior analysis is sound. The hard part is allowing the art to develop in you. In other words, you need to experience the contingencies as a behavior analyst to figure out what's going to work for you. So what works for me probably won't work for you, so on and so forth. So anyway, hope that kind of doesn't answer your question in a way that satisfies you. Bye.
So, did you like that behavior video? Behavior and video analysis. Did you like that video on behavior analysis? If you did, then like, subscribe, share, please.